Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to continue our series on Microsoft Teams, and we're going to talk about various images that you can have within Teams. We are going to go over the background images you can have when you're on screen, as well as your profile image when you're not on screen. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. So let's start with our background image. If I go down here to the desktop version of Microsoft Teams and I launch Teams and I go over here to Meetings and then I click Meet Now, I will be brought to a screen where I can configure a bunch of options for my meeting. If I click the button here, I will be brought to all of my settings for my speakers, my microphone, and my camera. And I can change which speaker or microphone or camera that I am using right here. But for now, I would like to keep them all, so I'm just going to exit from here. Also down here, you can see that my camera is off. But if I enable my camera, I can click here and go to background filters. This one up here takes off any filters that I have put on. This one blurs my background image. So if you're doing a call from home and you don't want people to see what's in your background, you can hit the blur. But there's a lot of other options here too. Here's a room. Here's some abstract art. Here's the locker room. And here's the beach. So you can pick any of those that you like. You can also go up here and go to add new. And you can pick a background that fits the criteria for a Microsoft Teams background. And just hit open. And you can see that that background has been applied. So once I have all my settings straight here, I can just go to join now. And you can see that my meeting starts off with that background image that I have selected. If I go up here to more, I can go down to apply background effects. And you can see that my background choices are very similar right here. But one big difference is this preview button. So if I click a new background and I click preview, I can see what that background is going to look like before I apply it to my meeting. So if I like that background, I can just hit this button here that says apply and turn on video. And now I'm working with the locker room background. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. If you would like more options for Microsoft Teams backgrounds, there are some available on Microsoft's website. If you scroll down, you can see some different choices. If you're interested in finding more backgrounds, then I will include this link right here in the description of this video. So basically what you would do is click on a group and then click on download background, and that background will be downloaded to your computer. And if you go back to Microsoft Teams, you can click add new and navigate to where you have saved that image. Next, let's go over the image for when your camera is off. Right now, if I turn my camera off, my image to everyone else is just my initials, but I can actually change this background image. And I can do that through my Microsoft.com account. So if I go to teams.microsoft.com and I click on this icon up here in the top right, and I go to manage account and I go to manage, I can click on your info and I can hit change photo right here. And if I go to add a photo, for now, I'm just going to pick the Excel icon and hit save and hit close. When I go back to Microsoft Teams, I can click Meet and hit Meet Now. You can see that I will be joining with my new profile picture instead of just my initials. So if I hit Join Now, inside my meeting, people will now see the Excel icon that I have set as my profile picture and not just my initials. So hopefully that gives you a good introduction to some of the images that you can change inside of Microsoft Teams. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below and we'll respond as soon as we can. Thanks for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.